Templates are a great way to make global updates to pages, just like we can with elements in CSS. In this chapter, we will also look at in-context editing and the best way to allow clients to update their sites. Let's get started.
Now, there are several different types of templates that we're going to take a look at. Basically, one is a Dreamweaver-driven template, and then we're going to take a look at using WordPress, which is also a type of template. Templates are great for working within a group. So let's say that you have one person particularly adept at using Dreamweaver, and that person can make the template. So then let's say that we have an entire different department or a junior division that needs to work within a particular part of the site and make updates to the pages. So those people don't need to know everything there is about Dreamweaver. They really just need to be able to take the part of the page that they want to update and just update that part. And we don't want to have to worry about them messing with navigation and other parts of the page that don't necessarily need to be messed with. Templates are also great for controlling a large design and have areas that we're going to reuse within the layout. So let's say we have an element like a copyright or a logo, and we can create library items out of those, and that template enables me to update multiple pages at once. So a document that's created from a template remains connected to that template until you detach, the document later if you want, and you can modify a template and immediately update the design and all the documents based on it. First, we need to take a look at redefining our site root. So I'm going to go to my Files panel and, like always, go and edit my Chapter 10, which is now Chapter 11. And I'm going to navigate to those files on my desktop. I'm going to choose Open and Select and now Save. And now it's going to update all those for me, and I can just say done. So we have several different types of regions to a template. So I can have an editable region, a repeating region, an optional region, and an editable tag attribute. So let's take a look at the very first type. The very first thing that we need to do is make something from a blank page. So if I go to File and New, we've been using just the HTML page type and the layout, but now we're going to choose HTML template, or I could choose a blank template from an HTML template from here as well. So if I choose, let's say, two column fixed sidebar, header and footer, I have the same options that I would normally have with a CSS page layout. I would create a new file, or I could link to an existing file. The one thing that we really would not want to do here is add to head, because then that's a part of that particular document. It really works best to update parts of your template by having your CSS be external. So we're going to create a new file. And I will say create. We need to put this somewhere. So I will put this in my CSS and we'll just call it blank temp.css and I will say save. So now I'm going to go over to design view for just a second. And we need to actually save this as a template. So I'm going to go to File and Save as Template. And it's just letting me know that this template doesn't have any editable regions. Am I sure I want to continue? I say sure, okay. Now it asks me where I'm going to save it. It's going to show me if I already have any existing templates, which we don't at the moment. And I'm going to save it as, I'll save it as blank temp, and I will give it a description of new template, and say save. Now, if you take a look at your files panel, you'll see that we now have a templates folder and the DWT that we had just created. And here it is. So first off, I need to create some editable regions. Now, I would normally come in here and do anything I want to do to this particular document, like change the logo, change everything about this that I would want to change. Then if I have a particular region, let's say our header one here. So I'm going to choose the header one in my tag selector. And I'm going to go to my insert menu and template objects and editable region. So I'm going to name this header and I'll click OK. And now that entire region is going to be editable. Now why I didn't do just everything is because maybe I want to do something separate to that next section, for instance. So here, I don't want the whole entire thing. So now I can insert template objects and editable region, and I'll just call that content and click OK. Now that's inside of my other container, but that's all right because I want my header separate for this particular template. Now I might want to take anything that I have in a footer and actually make it into a library item, but we'll show you how to do that in just a second. So all I really have to do is go to File and Save, and now I have myself a blank template. So now that we've made a blank template that we would normally just say File and New, what about a file that we already have that we would like to make into a template? So in your files panel, there is an about.html. Go ahead and open that. So this particular file really has everything that we probably would want to have inside of a template. This basically looks like the majority of our pages with very little difference. One thing that we can also do, and even inside of a template, is make a library item. Now, one thing that would make a great library item is our copyright information. So, for instance, it says 2010 right now. Well, what about next year? So, if I want to be able to change this easily, I probably want to make this into a library item. So, how I do that is I go to my Assets panel, and down at the very bottom on the left-hand side is my library, and I don't have anything in here at all right now. So I don't really want absolutely everything to be a part of my library. I'm going to go ahead and just highlight this last little bit of information here, just my copyright information. I'm going to grab it and I'm going to drag it into this top area over in my library. And it automatically says, well, what do you want to name that? So I'm just going to call it copyright. And then when I take a look at my file, I see it highlighted in yellow. Now there was white text in there, so you really don't notice it too much at all until I click on Live View and I can actually see that it is still there. Now over on the right-hand side where I'm in my assets, I see some of my copyright stuff here, and if I double-click that, it opens up in a new file with an extension of LBI, so my library item. So here is where I can alter that at. Notice that the styles don't really come across with a library item.
It really is just the text or whatever you dragged over there only.
So let's pretend that it's 2011 and I just save this. I'm going to update any of those pages, and I just have it on the one page right now. And it's going to tell me when I'm done, and now I can close. Notice that it also would have updated a template as well. So when I close this back out and I go back over to my live view, now my copyright says 2011. So that is a great way to work with a library item. So now that this file has a library item in it, let's go ahead and finish out making this file into a template. So if this is just really my about page, and again, my style sheet is an external style sheet, and that's really pretty important that we keep it that way when we're working with Dreamweaver templates. It's just going to make your life easier because then I can still edit the CSS without having to open up the template to do so. Otherwise, I would have to open up the template itself. Now, before I can save this as a template, I need to get out of my live view so I can save it. So I'm going to uncheck my live view, and now I'm going to go back to File and Save as Template. So kind of just like before, we already have an existing template in there. This is going to be our Pages template, and I'm going to save it as Pages. I only have a few pages so far in my site, so I already have some pages that reference other pages like my locations, etc. So I might want to go ahead and make those into a template now before I really get any more pages and base all of my pages off of this. So then I don't have to worry about updating any menu items. If I add more menu items or I take away menu items, I would just go back to my template file and update from there, and it's going to update all of my child pages also. So I'm going to go ahead and click Save, and I'm going to update my links. Well, now we've got really just a template, but we don't have anything defined. So just like I did before, I'm going to select my H1, and I'm going to go to my Insert, Template Objects, and I'm going to choose Editable Region, because we need at least one editable region. So I'm going to name this header, and I want to make sure that I'm selecting that tag first, because if I didn't, let me go to my code and show you, because if I didn't, it wouldn't wrap around the tag itself, then I would get an error from having done that. So I'll go back to my design view, and now I can take this whole entire section. And if I put my cursor in there, I notice that I have a div around that particular section. So I can select that. I can go to Insert, Template Objects, and Editable Region. And that's going to be my content. So another thing that I might make into an editable region is my sidebar area. Because if this is really going to be kind of my basic area here, I probably don't care about this being called recordings. I might want this to be something else entirely. So I'm going to select that whole entire div and then choose my Insert, Template Objects, and Editable Region. And I will call that sidebar. If I think I might want people to update the menu as well, I could add that into my template. Chances are, it's probably not an area that I would want anybody to update. So I think that we're pretty much okay with just that. I already have my library item at the bottom of my page, and so I feel pretty good to go on this. So I'm going to save it, and now next, we can see what it's like opening up a brand new document based on this template. So in our last lesson, we made this particular template that we're looking at right now, our pages.dwt. So now we can make a page based off of this particular template. So if I go to File and New, I'm able to choose Page from Template. So not blank page, not blank template now, just Page from Template. And I'm going to choose my Pages template over here. And one thing I want to make sure of is checking this box to update my page when the template changes. So I'm going to click on Create. And this is an untitled document. So if I go over my code, I will see that it goes all the way back to my computer home. And I really don't want that, so I want to make sure and save this right away before I start making any changes to it, so that all of my links will be relative to my site root instead of my computer. So I'm going to save that as locations.html inside of my Chapter 11 folder, and I will click Save. So now I could make changes, and we'll just get rid of the about. And so we'll make just a couple of changes here. Okay, then I could start making changes over my sidebar and over in my content at this point. And I'm just going to save my page for just a minute. Now, if I want to update this page in any way, I can go back to my pages.dwt and make those changes there. So, for instance, if I come back to my pages.dwt, and maybe I want to add something here. So let's say we're going to add locations. So this is an unordered list. So I'm going to hit return. And add that into my menu. And we will browse to that file. There's my locations. And OK. So now if I save this, it asks me, do I want to update that particular template file? So if I go ahead and update it, then when it's done, I can say close. And now when I go back over to locations, now that is updated in my file. So you can see working with templates is pretty easy and definitely worth learning. In this lesson, we're going to talk about the basics of using something like WordPress, which is a content management system that was really initially used for blogs, but has really grown drastically. And Dreamweaver CS5 allows you to be able to see those related files in those PHP pages like never before. So we've got different types of content management systems. So we're going to talk about WordPress, but there's Joomla, Drupal, and lots of other types of content management systems that you can use with Dreamweaver. So you'll want to look up those specifications for those particular sites. All the documentation for installing WordPress on both Mac and PC can be found on WordPress.org's website. So first off, I'm on a Windows machine, so I went to WampServer.com and downloaded the latest version of their WAMP server, which at the moment is 2.0i. And that's WAMPServer.com. So I just followed the initial directions for their own, and then I started all of the services. And what I ended up with is in my local host, I have an admin, I created a database, and what you're seeing now in my browser is my database from my WordPress site. Then you follow your directions on installing WordPress, and there is a 5-minute install, and it works pretty great. So there's a WP config sample file that we just changed to WP config. And then it shows you exactly how to set that up correctly. As long as I've set things up correctly, then I end up with the ability to see my site inside of my browser. And if I wanted to, I could go ahead and make all of my changes right here inside of my browser. But that's really not the point of being able to use Dreamweaver, and with Dreamweaver, we can edit the pages themselves a whole lot easier. So I'm going to go back to my Dreamweaver page, and I'm going to redefine for that particular root folder. Now, I already have this up here, so let me manage my sites and edit this and show you what I've basically done. So at this point, I need to do two things. So I've got my site name, and I need to show it where my site root folder is. So at this point on my PC, I have a WAMP folder on my C drive and a www folder, and I've put my WordPress files in there. And then in my servers section, I need to set up a testing server so that I can actually see what those pages look like inside of Dreamweaver. So I edit this, and I can give this a server name. And I'm just going to call it testing server for now. Then I'm going to connect using my local network, and my server folder, then I show where that is, and so that's my WAMP folder, my www folder, and my WordPress folder. And then my local host, I set up so I can still get to my WAMP information, and I chose WordPress for my web URL. So all of those files are inside of those folders inside of my machine. And now I just click on save and save here, and I will say done. And now if I take a look at my index.php, I get a chance here to say discover. So discover is going to then look for any related files that go with that. So I'm going to click on discover, and it's going to say you must discover dynamically related files in order to list them in the related files toolbar. And I will click on yes. So now I see a big long list of files up here that go along with that. And I can actually even scroll. So lots of different files here, and I can show just my CSS, just my PHP, or just my XML in this. So what it really likes me to do is switch to live view. And when I switch to live view, I actually see my page just like I did inside of my browser. Now, if I also click on live code at this point, and I'll move this over just a little bit so you can see a little bit better. Now, when I roll my cursor over something, or if I click on a particular area, so I see my hello world, I actually see where that's at inside of my code. So I can work with my WordPress file inside of Dreamweaver so much easier than ever before. Honestly, it would have been much, much more difficult than anything prior to Dreamweaver CS5.